Ladies and gentlemen, we will present to you the no water freedom, no food democracy, Gaza Emergency Mass, in the presence of these pertinent gods of the moment, and that you would be afraid of them because of my religion. Then the first god is the god of guaranteed water, never ending water. Next one is the god of food. Next one is the god of medicine, the little pill that cures all ills. Next one, god of electricity. Genocide God, very special, very needed at this moment. The God of the day. Okay. Now we want to turn to our readings.
Thank you. genocide. Please welcome to the stage the gates of hell and their scripture readers.
Into the mouth of hell for processing. NPR, November 18th. On December 13th, Israel authorities told Gaza residents to evacuate to southern Gaza, claiming it to be safer. More than 3,600 people have been killed in the areas where Israel told civilians to escape to. I will now feed the scripture of the day into the mouth of hell for processing.
From Poet's Vanity by Friedrich Nietzsche. I'll find wood. Just give me substance strong enough to bind like glue. Cramming sense in rhyme is nonsense worthy of a boast or two. I will now feed the scripture of the day into the mouth of hell for processing.
New York Times, November 19th. Israel is trying to produce evidence for its claims that Hamas has been using tunnels under Gaza's largest hospital as a command center. Palestinian officials and doctors at Al-Shifa have denied that the hospital is being used by Hamas. I will now feed the scripture of the day into the mouth of hell for processing.
Processing, please.
Of hell, the result of the processing. And place the result under the God of the day, the anti-genocide God, and we will take him on a parade for this to be buried. Okay, so we will now proceed to go
right this way to the ballroom.
The situation, very severe, no hearing. Now we will try to change this situation with the help of a lot of ears. All ears. Situation. Now we can hear.
Because now we offer screaming rants against the ultimate horrors.
Nah. Against. Important characters of this current situation. First being the decider. Now, decider dance, please. The second character of this current situation is the exterminator. Exterminator, please. Very necessary to explain this current situation.
We now present a typical freedom and democracy cultural event. In the presence of Mr. Death and his machine gun. And three unfortunate people who have lost their bowls because they are empty.
Mama.
Mr. President?
No, no water!
Democracy!
No food!
Freedom!
No, no electricity!
Democracy!
No, no medicine!
Freedom!
No, no water!
No, no food!
Freedom!
No electricity!
No medicine! Freedom! Democracy! Freedom!
We'll see you in 2024, Mr. President.
Right.
Obviously, sense is what our civilization is most proud of. Sense can be perceived through profit. Profit being sense. The two terms are equal. Profit is created
in this country through its most important industry, the arms industry, as depicted here, with bombs falling on the heads of somewhat rebellious population. We will now present to you a typical arm dance. Arm dancer, please. Now let's take a look at the second concept of this bedsheet, nonsense. Nonsense equals life. It is just the plain, old, unpretentious life that has no interest in efficiency, profit, or productivity. We will now demonstrate a typical nonsense life dance from Glover, Vermont. Nonsense dancer.
Thank you.
For the final bed sheet.
Thank you.
Success, one merely succeeds at turning distress into further success and success into further distress.
Ta-da!
I shall elaborate. In Exhibit A, we see the word bad.
Bad!
A very small, ordinary, dialectic, non-entity of a word which derives its meaning primarily from its opposite, the word good.
Good.
Which, in normal life, bad usually overshadows.
Overshadows.
Next slide, please. In Exhibit B, we see the word worse, a Teutonic word meaning war.
Ah!
War is the aggressive solution to the above stated dialectic indecisiveness. Furthermore, war is invented in that part of the brain which is afflicted by hopelessness.
Hopelessness.
In Exhibit C, we see the word worst, the inevitable result of Exhibit B, unimaginable pain.
Ouch.
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 As promoted by two opposing forces. These two forces are the terrorists, who are illegitimate, and the horrorists, who are legitimate. Terrorists promote fear, whereas horrorists promote peace and harmony.
Ta-da.
Peace being the enjoyment of total military superiority,
ta-da,
and harmony, the act of compliance with the exercise of total military superiority.
Ta-da!
And now, in Exhibit E, we see a quantitative comparison of these two opposing forces. The terrorists, who are here depicted in the corner as this tiny cockroach, and the horrorists, who are here depicted as this colossal Tyrannosaurus Rex, who is coincidentally related to the industrial military complex, and in whose footsteps of extinction we can only hope that they shall soon follow.
Yeah.
And therefore, in conclusion, we invite you, the students of success, to return home to your moms and your dads.
Come in.
Come in. Come in.
Mm-hmm.
And we ask that they enroll you in a more worthwhile pursuit of study.
Get out!
Thank you.
Now for the sermon of the day, the rant of the day. Civilization that routinely produces large quantities of dead as part of its merchandise. Traditional empathy succumbs to the vast statistics of meaningless anonymous deaths as reflected in the empire's budget called defense budget, meaning aggression budget, and now actively engaged elected, now openly fascist administration? How will design. Constructed human safeguards, treaties, international conventions, abandoning all habits of decency and morality, treating its subjects like the shit they are in their eyes, the empire nothings and nowheres, useful only once every 4 years for a billionaire-rigged election. And we... with our money? Can we afford to be subject to this murderous system? What could be a worse violation of our human rights than bombing hospitals and send the murderers to investigate the crime? No water, food, electricity, medicine. The publicly declared intention to kill them all. Institutions of basic human rights. Where are the preventions and stops of this ultimate brutality? And has this bombing hospital civilization lost its right to exist? Right? The original, glorious, whole, which obliges us to our habitual or extra habitual everyday euphoria, obliged to fight the genociders. So now we have to do some habitual, extra habitual euphoria exercises in order to be reminded how to do this. Euphoria exercise number is one. Euphoria exercise number two. Steal down, do it down, do. Euphoria exercise number three. That's enough. The rest the kids will show you. Yes, they know what to do. End of the song. Okay, when are you?
The wrong idea of the band.
So we need to go outside for that.
How about we burn it in the fire?
Or throw
it in the fire. Can we have the appropriate sound accompaniment?
Sure, yeah. This is baked last week. It's a 24-hour baked pumpernickel. Cures some of this part. Thank you.